Well, Chief is a stray dog who is rounded up with all the dogs in the city of Megasaki. And he's been exiled on this island to live out his days in discomfort because there's a fear of dog flu. It's not real, but the rhetoric and the propaganda against dogs is believed. So every dog from the city is put on this island called Trash Island. It's the island where they dump all the trash. And symbolic of that is the dogs are treated like garbage.
Well, a mascot is someone that gets taken along for the ride. When there's going to be a great success, the chance of a great success, when there is the chance of a great success, you need a mascot. Someone that's going to be with you when things get tough, but someone that you're really going to want to be there when things go well.
Rex describes himself as sleeping on a lamb's wool beanbag next to an electric space heater. He's probably comfortably middle class, maybe upper middle class, but he has work ethic. He's scrappy. At the same time, psychologically, Trash Island, it's difficult for him.
I admired Spots. I thought Spots was a very nice dog. He's a really good. I would love to have a dog like Spots, and it was very strange to think about how to play him. I just felt like he had a real sense of duty and a real sense of honor and really cared about people. Because I don't normally get to play those kinds of characters.
I was stroking this Scotch Terrier, and he bit my thumb, and I started to pull it away, and he wouldn't release. He didn't growl, he just simply bit it and held it. And I almost fainted. But it didn't instill in me a terror of dogs. But I understood from that experience how it could.
And I love his name, Duke. It reminds me of, would you know who I'm talking about if I said, would you know who I was talking about? Of course, Duke Ellington. That's right, Duke Ellington.
What does Nutmeg see in Chief? Sort of a survivor. She knows what it's like to lose something and come back stronger and not be afraid of what lies ahead. You know, she knows what it's like to be that kind of dog. And plus he's just the right amount of bite.
When I was little, my grandfather and my uncle each owned a kind of a movie studio. At one point, when I was about 10, I broke my arm and nobody knew what to do with me. So we took a train to Los Angeles. And the day after I got there, they put me in my nicest outfit. You know, I looked like Little Lord Fauntleroy or a Jewish Little Lord Fauntleroy. And I showed up at MGM to watch the filming of a movie called Meet Me in Las Vegas. And I got to sit in a special chair with my name on it. And I think probably after that, you might as well have exposed me to some crystal meth or something at the age of 10, because I craved it ever since that day.
Dogs are, they're given by God in a way, and they're a responsibility to use, not as a servant, but as a sounding board, as a demonstration of what your obligation is to life. That you must serve. You know, when you wake up in the morning, you know, the ranchers say you got to take care of your cattle before you feed yourself.
Oracle is a pug, specifically a companion breed pug. This breed is often described by the Latin phrase multum in parvo, or much in little, or a lot of dog in a small space. The heart of a dog is a bottomless thing.